I got something beautiful for you right now. I was interviewed by the Washington Times yesterday. Listen to this.
Dr. Savage, good afternoon. How are you?
I'm good. I wish I were better, but I can't be better because every day is another shock to the system.
How important is it to the future of this nation to rid ourselves of this president come November?
Well, look, if you like Fidel Castro, I think that he's a perfect candidate to be president for life. But if you like America, where success is rewarded, not poverty, where success is not punished, but poverty is punished, where our allies are respected and our enemies are attacked. I mean, this guy has everything backwards. He uses the military as a pawn. Our borders have descended into absolute chaos. Corporations and cronies make off with all the wealth. The people are screaming. And the fact of the matter is, his most deep-pocketed campaign donors and allies are getting fat grants and contracts. Did you see the article this morning that he's diverted $500 million in tax money?
To the IRS.
To the IRS to make sure that Obamacare is upheld even if the court turns it down?
Yeah, a little presumptuous, huh?
No, it's a dictatorship. You know, so when I say to people, trickle-down tyranny, I'm not just using it as hype. I have 300 or more pages of facts here. This is a terrifying situation. Look, even Democrats, and this is an interesting point, even Democrats are frightened of this administration. Because Obama is out of touch with the mainstream of the Democrat Party. He is something different. We have never had an extreme leftist of this variety in the White House. This is the first time. And the Democrats are terrified. And you know, the fact is we've had an election, which was a mandate on whether or not America wanted to move this far to the left. It was in 2010. The Republicans swept in virtually every election. The media would have you believe that we don't really know where the American people stand. Nothing can be further from the truth. The election said nobody wants to be dragged into the far left in 2010. The problem is the Republicans have done such a great job of killing each other that we don't even know if Obama will be defeated. That really is the issue, don't you think?
Yeah, it's sad. Very sad. We've seen the 99% crowd, a battle over free contraception, an attempt at a race war, his slap at the Supreme Court, his lecturing of the press on how to report on him, yet he still appears to have half of America ready to vote for him. How?
It's very simple. Over half of America doesn't pay taxes, do they? That's the half that loves Obama. They like you and I working our behinds off to pay for their pleasure, don't you think?
Yeah, yeah. Now we
it's how every demagogue works, which is appeal to the lowest common denominator, attack the productive and call them the rich, support the bums and call them the victims. This is nothing new. See, everything that he's saying has been tried somewhere else. Europe's moving away from this. The European governments are moving away from this far-left mentality. What worries me is not just the socialism that we see creeping into our country, and we're 50-60% there anyway. It's the tyrannical nature of Obama. Who listening to this show can say that they're not frightened of this man's imperiousness, his arrogance, the vacations, the First Lady's repeated vacations and arrogance? It's as though we're living with a king and a queen, not a president and a First Lady.
Mm-hmm. I'd mentioned the press just briefly. You have an excellent description of what once was a great journalistic society in this country. What happened to them?
After World War II, you had men returning from war who were these grizzled, hardened, alcoholic smokers who wouldn't let a fly go by without analyzing it correctly so, because they didn't want tyranny to evolve. The tough old type of reporter that doesn't exist anymore. And they were, eventually, they died off, and we now have what you call the Society of Professional Journalists. Need I say more? The fact of the matter is these are all geldings.
Yeah.
They were specifically picked to enter journalism school because they were not these gung-ho, defend America, defend the Constitution types. These were kids who couldn't do anything else, frankly, so they went into journalism school. I'm very harsh on it because I see what they've done. The job of the press is to be a pit bull for the American people, not to be a lapdog of the administration to get invited to dinners. And that summarizes it all, don't you think?
Yep, I do. And in fact, with the passing of Mike Wallace this past weekend, I thought, there goes the last one. I mean, there was a guy who I thought was the pit bull you spoke of.
Well, his son, Mr. Meatball Jr., is on Fox News with a different...
Chris.
I mean, Mr. Meatball Jr. is there. I mean, he pretends to be a tough journalist. And
no, he's a registered Democrat. I called him out on that, and he admitted it.
I see. Well, how many others on Fox are registered Democrats?
You know, I don't know that.
I mean, you've got Scarface. I mean, what's her name? The Scientologist who pretends to be a journalist.
You're not talking about Greta, are you?
Yeah. The Scientologist. The Scientologist who went for a facelift and a campaign lift and came out and said, I'm on Fox News, but I'm still a registered Scientologist Democrat. And I'm supposed to believe a word she says?
Oh, man. All right, we're going to move
on. I'm sorry. Look, I don't mean to embarrass you.
No,
Look, I don't want to embarrass you. The fact is I'm banned in the United Kingdom and I'm banned on Fox News. To me, they're one and the same at this point.
Wow.
The fear here for me is that the trickle-down tyranny we all see is this. Are we going to remain the United States of America or become the USS of A, the socialist states of America? Will Obama transform the greatest engine of freedom the world has ever known into a Stalin-like dictatorship? Or can the American people wake up and throw this polarizing president out of office next November? That's what my entire book is about.
You know,
it's about the tyranny. The tyranny is what it's about. It's not an invention. It's there. It's factual.
I want people to read page 120 of your book, Trickle Down Tyranny. That's the name of the book, folks. Rules for Beating Radicals. I must admit, I love the fighting the fire with fire approach. I've always been like that. You got to challenge them. You got to call them out. Why doesn't the right do this? Why don't they take the garbage they spew and throw it right back in their face, Michael?
You know, it's funny you picked that because most of the readers who bought the book, it only came out last week, said to me they love the rules for beating radicals, meaning techniques, tactics. Can I read four headlines in there, please?
Yep.
Never believe a word that comes out of a Democrat's mouth. That's a safe thing to do. Never negotiate with a leftist Democrat because they have no good faith. Never compromise with a Democrat because to them compromise is a victory. Attack Democrats before they attack you. They have no core principles except the lust for power. Obstruct Democrats at every opportunity. Use the left's treatment of racial and ethnic minorities against them. Following Alinsky's rules, turn it back upon them. Why don't the conservatives do this? Why are they always playing catch-up? Because they think that they're too nice to fight. They think that there's something wrong with winning. And that is exactly why Romney is losing.
It's an important book, folks. It really is. You need to read it. It's brand new by Michael Savage, Trickle Down Tyranny, Crushing Obama's Dream of the Socialist States of America. Michael, great to talk to you. Good luck with the book, and keep on fighting the good fight.
Thank you very much for having me on. I appreciate it. Savage.